I can't believe this mandala was made in just 5 seconds. With only a text prompt. Look at all these, hundreds of pages. I'm gonna upload them all to Amazon and make $10,000 a month.
You know, AI can make some really cool coloring pages in just a few seconds. But here's the thing. Most people don't realize they can't really use many of those images for commercial purposes on Amazon KDP. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to create AI-generated coloring books that are commercially safe, ones you can confidently publish and profit from. And we'll also make sure they look professional and print-ready, because not every AI image comes out high resolution. Let's get started. Okay, first of all, Amazon KDP is not against AI-generated content. However, they require you to let them know if your book includes any AI-generated material when you publish a new book or make edits to an existing one. In my opinion, the reason Amazon asks for this is to shift the responsibility onto publishers, because the copyright status of AI-generated content is still in a gray area. As you've probably heard, there are already many lawsuits between creators and AI companies. So, in case any legal issues come up in the future, you will be the one responsible, since you've checked the box that says you own the copyrights.
I didn't know I couldn't use these commercially. I didn't realize it was copyright infringement.
The court finds that you have violated copyright law. You must cease commercial use immediately and compensate the rights holder for damages.
That also means Amazon could easily remove those books if there's ever a copyright problem, because we've clearly marked them as AI-generated. Again, this isn't official information, it's just my personal opinion. But since I want to build a sustainable business, I see this as a risky and unstable situation. That's why I personally prefer to use only Adobe Firefly image models whenever I need an AI-generated image for my books. And so far, I've never had a single issue. If you check their website, they're very clear about commercial usage, and honestly, not many AI models offer this level of transparency. Here's what they say. We developed Adobe Firefly to prevent it from creating content that infringes copyright or intellectual property rights, and it's designed to be commercially safe. We do not and have never trained Adobe Firefly on customer content. And we only train Adobe Firefly on content where we have permission or rights to do so. That's why I personally feel much safer using Adobe Firefly for image generation. Quick disclaimer before we move on. This is just my personal opinion and experience, not legal advice. Always double-check the terms of any tool you plan to use if you want to publish AI-generated content commercially. All right, now let's start creating some coloring pages. This is the Firefly homepage. If you want to try it yourself, I'll leave the link in the video description so you can test it after watching. Here, on the prompt box, select Image. Next, use the Model drop-down menu to select from Adobe's own models or partner models. One of the best features of Adobe Firefly is that you can explore different capabilities and styles across partner generative AI models, all within the same tool. That means you don't need separate subscriptions for each model. For image generation, you can choose from models like Flux, Gemini, GPT Image, and Runway models. For video, Firefly also offers Pika, Ray, Veo models, in addition to the Firefly video model. Okay, let's focus back on image generation and select one of the Adobe models. As you can see, it clearly marks these models as commercially safe. For this demo, let's select the latest model, Firefly Image 5. Use the aspect ratio option to define the dimensions of your image. You can choose this according to your page size. Most coloring books on Amazon use a square format, so we'll keep it 1:1. Now you can enter your prompt and click Generate, just like any AI image tool. Or if you want, click More to add a reference image. If you try other models like Firefly Image 4 Ultra, you can also select the content type, art, photo, or let Firefly Auto choose based on your prompt. The visual intensity slider lets you control the intensity of visual attributes in the image. Under composition, you can define a structure or composition by uploading a reference image. The styles section is great if you want the generated image to match a specific visual style or aesthetic from a reference image. You can also apply specific effects for color and tone, lighting, and camera angle if you need a particular style. To keep things simple for this video, I'll go back to Firefly Image 5 and enter my prompt. In the prompt field, type a detailed description of the image you want to create. This is where you guide the AI to generate your coloring page exactly the way you want it. You can also use the prompt features option here to enable prompt suggestions. This lets Firefly suggest ideas as you type your description, which is really helpful if you're not sure how to phrase your prompt. But for now, I'll use my own prompt, this one. And let's hit generate. Since we chose the Firefly Image 5 model, it will generate a single image. If you choose Firefly Image 4, it generates 4 image variations. Okay, our commercially safe coloring. Book page is ready. If you click the edit options in the top left corner of the image, you'll see a few choices. You can open the image in Firefly's image editor, where you can use the prompt to edit feature to modify it with text-based prompts, or you can open it directly in the generative fill editor to add or remove visual elements, or even expand the image. You can also simply use it as a reference image for your next generation. If you click directly on the image, it opens inside the Firefly image editor. Here you can modify it using text-based prompts, not just with Firefly models, but also with partner models like Gemini, GPT image, or Flux. Let's go ahead and download this image. Now if we go back and hover over the image, you'll see labels like commercially safe, and also details under content credentials, source, and AI information, like Thai's content is completely AI generated. Since our goal in this video is not only to create commercially safe images, but also professional, print-ready coloring pages, we need to check whether the image resolution meets publishing standards, especially for Amazon KDP. Images are made up of tiny dots called pixels. The number of dots per inch is known as DPI, and that determines the resolution or print quality of your image. For print, the standard is 300 DPI. As I mentioned before, for children's coloring books on Amazon, the most common format is 8.5 by 8.5 inches, a square layout. Even though our artwork won't go all the way to the edge in this example, I always prefer to include bleed margins, which makes the final file size 8.625 by 8.75 inches. Here's the simple formula for calculating pixels. Pixels needed equals inches times DPI. So if we want 300 DPI, the image should be around 2,587 by 2,625 pixels. Now, if you open the image, you'll see that our generated image size is 2,048 by 2,048 pixels. Well, honestly, that's pretty close, and it likely won't look blurry when printed. However, I'll show you how to increase the number of pixels using AI for even better print quality. You can use Photoshop or any AI upscaler to add pixels and improve resolution. That's the best way to properly increase image quality. And if you already have an Adobe Creative Cloud subscription, it's super easy. If not, you can grab the free trial link I've included in the video description below. If you hover over the image, you'll see a small Photoshop logo in the top right corner. If you click it, the image will open directly in Photoshop Web. Once it's open, click Generative on the left menu, then select Generative Upscale. For this example, a 2x upscale will be enough. The final file size will be 4096 by 4096 pixels, which is already much higher than the pixel requirement we calculated earlier. Then click Upscale, and once it's finished, click Download. Now, if you open the upscaled image, you'll see it's 4096 by 4096 pixels. Let me show you both images side by side for comparison. The upscaled image is on the right, and the original image is on the left. If you look closely, the original one looks a bit blurry compared to the upscaled version. So now we have an image that's both commercially safe and professional looking, ready for print. Just like this, you can create many different coloring book pages using Adobe Firefly and build a sustainable business without the risk of infringing on any copyrights or intellectual property rights.
Oh no, I have to start everything from scratch again. Wait, what was the Adobe Firefly website again?
As I mentioned, if you want to try Adobe Firefly, I'll leave the link in the video description so you can test it out after watching. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, don't forget to like the video and subscribe for more tutorials like this. See you in the next one.